Hi, welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make perfect rotis. So first step is to prepare the basic dough. You can use whole wheat flour, but I recommend that you use stone ground wheat flour that you can find at any Indian grocers. First, I'm going to add salt, just a pinch of salt. So I'm going to add about 1 tablespoon of oil. Give it a good mix. Add water slowly and prepare the soft dough. Alright, so this is perfect dough, soft. And now I'm going to smooth out this dough with just a little bit of oil. So I'm going to cover this with a plastic wrap and allow it to rest for 10 minutes. You can see how it looks like now after 10 minutes. Okay, so this is perfect. This is how I want. Now I'm going to use this rolling board and rolling pin. You don't have to have exactly like mine. You can use even counter to roll the bread. So it's really up to you. And here I have this cast iron tawa. You can use any flat nonstick pan or anything that you have in your kitchen. Turn on the stove on a medium heat. Now you can divide this dough into equal portion, about golf size of a ball. So take one ball at a time, flatten it out, dust with flour and start rolling. Now, if you are a beginner, you won't be able to roll it just the way maybe I'm doing it, but it's really okay. So this is ready. So just put it on a tawa. And I usually just keep rolling and keep baking. So now when you see a few bubbles on the first side, just flip on the other side. Now, I'm just going to bring it down onto the flame and it will balloon up like this. Just bring it onto the towel. Now, if you want to keep them soft, then you can apply butter on top. So keep rolling and keep baking. Now you can increase the heat while you are bringing directly onto this flame so that it balloon up nicely. So I'm done preparing these rotis. They look wonderful, aren't they? And these rotis, you can just bend it however you like. You can see that they're still nice and soft. And these rotis are very light, so you can serve anytime with vegetables, the cooked vegetables or any kind of curries, or you can use it as a wrap. So you can use it for many, many other cuisine recipes as well. So I hope I made it easier for you how to make rotis. Or perfect rotis, I should say that. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great episode of cooking.